हेलो एवरीवन, आवर डिसेक्शन टॉपिक इज मीडियल कंपार्टमेंट ऑफ लेग. दिस इज डिसेक्टेड लेफ्ट लोअर लिम एंड हियर इज मीडियल कंपार्टमेंट ऑफ लेग. दिस मीडियल कंपार्टमेंट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय द मीडियल सरफेस ऑफ टीबिया. इट इज मोस्टली सबक्यूटेनियस एंड कवर्ड बाय स्किन एंड सुपरफिशियल फेशिया. इन अपर पार्ट देयर इज इंसर्शन ऑफ 3 muscles, sartorius, gracilis and semitendinosus and tibial collateral ligament. All these are covered by thin layer of deep fascia. In lower part, great saphenous vein and saphenous nerve are present. First we will discuss these two. This great saphenous vein, saphenous means easily seen. This is the longest vein of body and it starts from the dorsal venous arch. Okay, its formation is in the dorsum of foot. After its formation, it comes in the leg and it is related in front of this medial malleolus. And it crosses this lower one third of medial surface of tibia obliquely with backward inclination and runs upward and related one breadth behind the medial border of tibia up to knee, and in knee it passes behind the patella. Here is patella. It passes behind patella in the posteromedial part of knee and enter in the thigh. Okay, now saphenous nerve. Saphenous nerve is the longest cutaneous nerve of body. This saphenous nerve is a branch of femoral nerve. It is branch of posterior division of femoral nerve. Here you can see it is related behind the this great saphenous vein. This is saphenous nerve. Okay, this saphenous nerve, it is related with the medial border of tibia, and in the lower one third it give two branches. One branch run along with the medial border of tibia up to the ankle, and other branch crosses in front of ankle and reaches up to the this medial, reaches and supplies the skin of the medial side of dorsum of foot. And here you can see this saphenous nerve, it is also related in front of this medial malleolus, but it is just behind this great saphenous vein. So here is great saphenous vein and this is saphenous nerve. This is medial malleolus. They are very closely related to each other at in front of medial malleolus. So during venous action, one should take care not to injure this saphenous nerve. Now in the upper part of medial compartment, we have this tibial collateral ligament. This tibial collateral ligament is morphologically degenerated part of adductor magnus, and it is crossed superficially by this tendon of sartorius, gracilis and semitendinosus, and deep to it semimembranosus muscle is there. Gyrops. Gyrops are muscles from the each compartment of thigh, from the anterior compartment sartorius, from the middle compartment gracilis, and from the posterior compartment semitendinosus muscle. They get inserted on the
upper part of medial surface of tibia. These three muscles, they arise from the each component of hip bone. See, this sartorius is the muscle of front of thigh or flexure compartment of thigh, and it is supplied by the nerve to ilium, which is femoral nerve. Here is insertion of sartorius muscle. This is gracilis. Gracilis is muscle of medial or adductor compartment of thigh, and it is supplied by nerve of pubis, which is obturator nerve. And here is semitendinosus muscle. This semitendinosus muscle is muscle of back of thigh or flexure compartment of thigh, and it is supplied by nerve of ischium, which is sciatic nerve. These three tendons, they converge on this tibia at single point, on this upper part of medial surface of tibia at a single point, and above they spread out like strings of tent. Okay, so they act as a gyrops and they stabilize the bony pelvis on the tibia. Now, anserine bursa. Anserine bursa is complicated bursa, large complicated bursa with many diverticula, and this bursa is related with this insertion of sartorius, gracilis and semitendinosus muscle, and it separates these three tendons from each other and also from the bony surface of tibia and also from the tibial collateral ligament. Thank you.